हेलो हेलो एवरीवन, हेलो वेलकम। सो दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम स्ट्रीमिंग साइमल्टेनियसली। आई एम स्ट्रीमिंग ऑन माय पर्सनल यूट्यूब चैनल एंड ऑन द लीचेस चैनल एज वेल।
Ten,
आई गेस द
nine,
गेम्स आर अबाउट टू
eight,
स्टार्ट।
seven, six,
सो
five, four, three,
या
two, one, zero.
या वी हैव किक ऑफ एंड इट ऑल सीम्स ओके टू मी। द या ओनली थिंग इज आई डिड नॉट आई डोंट रिमेम्बर हाउ आई एम सपोज टू कैजल इन चेस 960, बट आई थिंक आई विल रिकलेक्ट इट ऑन टाइम। आई डिड प्ले इन द चेस 960 वर्ल्ड चैम्पियनशिप लास्ट ईयर। आई गॉट इन टू द राउंड ऑफ 16 वेर आई लॉस्ट अगेंस्ट ग्रैंड मास्टर साल्गाडो लोपेज़ फ्रॉम स्पेन। सो या थैंक यू सो मच पीपल। दिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ प्रिटी लॉन्ग अरीना एंड सो फार आई हैवन्ट thought for my moves, but yeah, 960 is not like the normal position number 518 in the normal chess where you can automatically play the first few moves. But I think yeah, after we get through the initial hiccups, it's going to be smooth. Okay, so attacking this, I defend this. So the first thing is to get the pieces out and control the center. It's the same in any format of chess, which is played with the existing rules and existing piece configuration. So I guess e5, he's progressing towards controlling the center, but this d6 pawn is slightly weakened, but he has this bishop out, whereas my c1 bishop is completely undeveloped right now. It is going to be a slow start to this tournament, just like how it was in the Bullet title arena. Yeah, it's castled. I can also do the same, and then it's a question of how to bring this queen out. But my pawn structure is slightly more flexible than his, so I can probably go for something like f4 at some point because he has already committed his pawn to e5. A6 wasn't really necessary for him at this point. I think I'll just go for f4, aiming to take back on f4 with my rook. Thank you so much, Sudarshan. Yeah, so he goes knight e5 next move, and I think I have to come back and be very careful about this pawn. So knight e5, rook f1, knight g4 looks not ideal for me. Then I have to give up one of my bishops. This is also not a bad move by him, but I can take this, yeah. This seems hanging. Yeah, I'm not sure if this was what he had intended when he played rook e7. So now I think this is my next. But yeah, I mean, he has 95 now, taking back my exchange. So he need not have played this bishop at 6. Yeah, so he wants to come queen c3 and stuff. I'm just late by one more. And although he's an exchange down, I don't think his position is bad. I think it's approximately equal. So what do I do? I think I'll just defend for now. Let him get under pressure of having to convert the better position. His queen can get to b2. But for now, it's not such a terrible loss. If I can get my pieces out, I don't mind giving up a pawn or two. Yeah, he saw the tactic. Bishop, this doesn't allow something like bishop g4, probably not right now. And but okay, good thing is I can get my queen out. Ah, I could have just taken this, yeah, but maybe it was yeah, I should have taken this. That would have been a better thing to do. I should just start playing a bit faster now. I just blundered this. But I got my rook to a pretty good square. Sorry, I got my bishop to a pretty good square, and I was hoping for something like this precisely. It's still he gets a lot of minor pieces, but okay. My position was not that great in any case at the beginning of this tactic. It's a lot of minor pieces for him. He has 3 minor pieces against the queen. In general, with such material dynamics, it's always better for the side with the minor pieces. But okay, I have some tricks going, so it's still not completely one-sided yet. He wants to play knight of 3 and take this. Yeah, this doesn't look good to me. But okay, I can just play. I cannot do this. Yeah, he takes and then gives knight of 3 check. Okay, I have to do something like this. And and try to survive as long as I can. Okay. Queen e1, bishop c3 is easy. Oh, that was a mouse slip. It was a mouse slip. Yeah. Okay. Okay. At least the stream is going well. So that's a good thing. No, queen j8 was not a mate. Bay Warriors, it was he always had king h6 going. Okay, great. Okay, decent start to the stream. Not the best start to the tournament, but it's these arenas, it's I think a lot more important to finish well rather than focus too much on the start. The last 30 minutes is going to in general, the last 30 minutes is what decides. But in general, getting a streak at any point is very useful. So it's all about streaks, and the individual game itself is not the most important thing or the end of the world. I'm playing against Melkumian. Melkumian is a pretty strong GM from Armenia, but I think right now he lives in Australia through this pandemic. We have a pretty close to a normal position, but these queens are feeling a bit out of place. Yeah, I think after some moves it's going to become like any normal position, extremely normal. Like something that came out of 1e4e5. Quite happy with how my potion has turned out. The thing is, all my pieces are out and playing, yeah, and right now it feels like his potions are a bit out of place. His pieces. I can actually take with the knight. But then he comes c4, yeah? Yeah, he probably will play c4, and now I think I can go f3 or knight g5. Knight g5 he just takes with knight f4. So f3, bishop h3, knight g5. Yeah, so I'm pretty happy with what I achieved with this bishop. Now knight g5, h4, knight h3, king h2, knight g4, king h3. And I can't quite find that finishing blow there. So knight g5, h4. There's something else I can do. Knight h3, king h2. I don't see the finishing blow. But probably one thing I can do is I can just hope that something turns up there. Or maybe just not go for knight g5 at all, yeah? Let's just I think I'll just for now take this knight out from here. He goes to e3 probably, and now what are my options? Feels like there should be something. Maybe just queen g5, intending knight f4. So he's going to go h4 here, and then I just come queen g6 and wait. So if there's no finishing blow, then there's absolutely no need for me to hurry up. My pieces are very strong in this position as well. Yeah, kind of what I expected. So far things have gone according to the plan, and unless I miss something very important, I think it's going to be completely winning in a couple of moves or so. So probably he goes knight d4 now. Yeah, knight d4, knight g4 check, knight g4, queen g4, and there will be a mate on h3. He has to take knight e2 then, and after fe2 I'm winning a rook. Yeah, so now I threaten mate here. I guess the only way to prevent it is to take knight e2. The other option is to play bishop g2, then I just take. Yeah, that was a good game. I'm pleased with that game. Thank you people, thank you. I'm playing against Amin Basim. He's also a pretty strong GM from Egypt, and I think the position I have is very similar to the position I had in my first game. I can actually start with the short castle here, but I think I'll make a non-committal knight more. So this bishop develops easily. I castle here, and maybe as I'm white, yeah, he played d5. I was planning to play e4 myself and try to take control of this center. So the problem with fixing this is this bishop is a bit restricted in the future. Yeah, I think I'll just castle first. Now I would like to get e4, but d4 hangs, so I'll play b3 first. So far it's pretty symmetrical. Having the white, having one extra tempo is definitely useful. Yeah, e6. I just want to go e4. Okay, if I take this, he wants to reply back with this. So if I start with this, then he wants to play d4. But then I have knight a4 retaining my pawn, so it looks like I'm winning a pawn. I don't know about the future, but for now I'm up a pawn. Yeah, if I allow this, then my pawn structure gets bad. But yeah, I think I'll just take this and play. I am up a few pawns. My opponent seems to be playing pretty fast though. He's playing pretty fast, but I like the position I have. There's nothing to complain there. So he wants to take this. This doesn't look great. And if I play queen e2, I'm not losing anything because d3 I have knight d3. I wanted to get e5 in, but after knight c6, f4, queen c2, he's doing well, I think. So I need to defend this first, and then oh yeah, I could have played c3, that would have been better, but it's okay. I should also probably not get into such a huge time deficit. I'm not Nihal Sarin. be fantastic if I can get my knight here. Yeah, this is kind of what I had calculated when he started this operation. Now, how can I get my knight to f6? I can start with knight e5, I can start with knight c5. Okay, if I take this, then he wants to take here. He's very tricky, yeah. He's not going to he's not going to allow me to execute my plans without opposition, that's for sure. Without resistance. If he takes on a2, then I have rook a1, so yeah, of course he goes here. Which allows me to get my knight to a good square for now. No, he doesn't allow me to get here. Okay. I try to get here. Or knight d7. Knight d7 is actually a legit threat. And I guess I win an exchange, yeah. I win an exchange and it's also nice. Maybe not. I missed this knight c3. But okay, rook d2 anyway. Then knight d3 is coming, yeah. Yeah, I think I may have been a bit outplayed through this phase. I should probably accept a equalish position and go. Okay, I should try and bail out here. I have absolutely no advantage remaining. How can I exit here? I need an exit strategy. It's full of tricks. Rook c1, no. Knight e2 check. It's tough to exit. Tough, but not completely impossible. That was just Shashwat. I think eventually there will be theory for chess 960. That's how we grow in everything. Yeah, it starts small, then as humans, as we keep contributing and keep contributing, we develop a theory in that field. It's the same for any subject. Yeah, true. Move first, think later. I should probably play a bit faster. I'm not entirely sure what you mean by how they attempt in poker, because I'm not such a good poker player. Okay, next game. I was just waiting a bit so I can get some slightly easier opposition, you know. Playing all this 2600s right from the start was it's not easy. Hopefully not that strong. This guy wants to play when he's right down to few seconds, yeah? The Nihal method. So again, the first position we look at the chess 960 position, we want to see how we can develop which pieces and stuff. Quite often there is also some obvious tactic. Here I feel I'll put my pawns in the King's Indian formation, or I'll try to do that. It's probably a bit harder to dictate the pace with black in chess 960, but I really don't have that much experience here to comment too much about it. But it's really nice that you can start thinking from the first move, you know, and get your creativity going, create new things instead of just repeating what is already known. So the plan is to put as much pressure as possible here. So he's forced to open up my rook. Yeah, I'm just winning a pawn now. I could just take it right away, or I can start with some b6. But if I start with b6, then now I'll just take the pawn. For now, I'll just take the pawn. Okay, I did not see this. If I play knight g3, he has knight f7 check. So we are down to an equal position now. I play queen e6, then bishop d5, so I think I'll just develop my knight for now. I'll probably castle long, queen d7 and castle long is the plan. Because if I castle short, this bishop is going to be exchanged with b3 and my king can be pretty soft. So queen d7 and castle long. Paras, no, there hasn't been any update. I'll let you know if there's an update on the streams tomorrow. But it's going to be a while, I think. Yeah. So I have no option but to take this, play queen d7 and castle long. Not really. Not the kind of position I thought I was getting. Not the position I needed, but probably the one I deserved. He's playing well so far, he's putting his pieces on good squares. Thank you so much, Venkatesh. This is the intention. Although this is not a very proud strategic thing to be. Do not try this at home or school. But I also locked him here. That you should try. This is soft. Let me get this out first. So he's forced to play some knight d5 hopefully. But yeah, he just plays f3, yeah? And then he threatens to take this with check. So I can play rook d8. This is a simple defense. I wonder why it took so long for this. Not what I had foreseen. Although I don't feel so much in danger, because it feels like there are counter options. Queen g4 among others. It's not so easy for him to play here. Lot of threats, lot of tricks. It's like how I had to deal with so many tricks in the previous game. Yeah, rook d3 was kind of what I was expecting, but after knight f4 check, it feels like I win something. I win a rook. Oh yeah, I completely forgot, like knight d3 has fg, yeah? This was not a... Okay, I go back. Yeah. So given time, he's playing quite well. I need to play a move which really puts him under pressure. Queen h3 is a threat. So just knight g5 for now. The idea of knight f3. Yeah, now I go rook e to check. It's tricks and threats all around. Okay, I need to focus for sure. Just take this for now, I think. He has survived the worst. Now it's my turn to survive. Okay, I don't mind a draw. Because if I move my knight, he's going to meet me here, so I had to take this. Yeah, it's a very slow beginning. But it's a very, very long tournament too. Very long tournament. Steven Rojas from Peru. So what's this position? I can definitely not go here. This is going to be hit right away. I think I'll put my bishop here, that looks nice. Thanks for the super chat, Ashwin. Okay, develop with tempo. Develop with tempo, but my queen is a long way off. The good thing, the flexible thing about this setup I'm having is I can castle this way also, and I can castle long also. That is the flexibility. Yeah, so now he starts to mess things up a bit. I'm certainly better here. I should probably get my knight here. I should, I guess I should pay attention and see that I'm not missing something concrete or tricky. This is such a nice position to get after just 12 moves. I also had this the previous move, which I noticed only now. But I guess I'll just pretend that I didn't take it, so I didn't want to compromise on my development. Yeah, so next I want to castle long. And that will, I think, bring out pretty much all my pieces. It's such a nice feeling to, you know, just play chess according to these general principles, or, you know, yeah. Chess 960 really helps bring this out. It helps. It really shows the difference in chess understanding between people, and the modern chess which we play today, it certainly helps bridge the gap with a lot of opening theory. I think opening theory certainly helps in playing some German WFM. What's the position like? Which piece? I'll start with this bishop. Okay, hitting this. These kind of tactics are generally easy to miss on in chess 960 because we are not looking for hanging pieces initially, hanging pieces or pawns. So even very strong players tend to miss such tactics early in the game. Tactics and tricks. The first thing to watch out for in chess 960. It also slightly doesn't help that chess 960 is always played with fast time control. Ah, okay, I missed this. It's like tit for tat, but fortunately I have knight g3, saving my rook with this. And now bishop e4 actually threatens to trap this queen. That was hilarious, you know. I was talking for a few minutes about how these tricks are easy to miss, but foreknowledge is not always useful. Yeah, Nihal is playing the Asian Championship. Thank you, Divya. Thank you for your kind words. I do try to emulate you in the things I do. So good to see that I'm on my way, and good to get that note of approval from you. Yeah, I guess it also fits that, you know, you when you're teaching or displaying stuff, you have to show it from both the sides. That feels like desperation, yeah. She couldn't stop this, so okay, it's only mo. I was in check. I had no square for my king, and here I think after queen f3, it's game over. I'm just a piece up, and the queen will be exchanged. I can also play queen e5, hitting this and this. Now, if she plays knight g6, then I take bishop g6. So that's also pretty tempting and a greedy option. I think I will learn something from my captain. Take a leaf out of Greedy Weedy's book. Now, I'll just make sure this queen goes out from here, and then I'll take this. Thank you, people. Okay, I'm surprised that she hasn't resigned yet, because it's a rook up. It's very very large material deficit for black, but my king on d2 is not the best, so that is a reason to keep the game going. But okay, this position is so good for white, you know, like after d5 I have rook c5 check, and if knight c5 bishop f5, I can do the same thing starting with bishop f5, and I can even take this. Okay, this is defended, so now I have the option to either play e3 or rook c5 check. Rook c5 check, king b7. After that, I might have multiple threats to deal with, so I'll start with e3. Rook c5 check, next move. Yeah, f6 was what I was expecting. I can, of course, just take this, yeah, it's the simplest thing to do. Okay, that was a nice win. Yeah, it's very nice to play chess like this. Bringing out concepts from the first move. Yeah, it's a good question why Divya bullies me. Something I've never found an answer to. But what can we do, I mean? It's also pretty useful to get this 20 seconds in Chess960 to plan how you want to develop. So here it's pretty easy to castle, and that makes it kind of normal. This bishop gets developed easily. This is pretty much like English opening pawn structure, and pawn structure is the first thing we notice in chess, first concept of strategic chess. It's like the skeleton of the position, any position. So in the beginning, it's very useful if either side can get a good center. Slightly surprised at that move, but d4 isn't really a threat, so it also makes sense. I'm guessing white should challenge with d4 at some point. Yeah, that's what he did. Now, these positions can be a slight nagging edge for white quite often. I do hope I don't end up in such a situation. Now, c5 is a threat. Like, if I go e6, c5 is there. I can play knight d6, c5, knight e4. At least one of my pieces is out. Not the happiest with the ensuing pawn structure, but it's not so bad as well. So try and see how it works. Good pawn structure for white. Somewhat. But this. Yeah, okay. Also this is possible. Would be handy if I could have got f6 at some point, but I would like to get dc4, you know, this bishop is opened. I'll probably take with bc and I'll take e6. And I think it's close to equal. Although, it's probably equal. I think black is doing okay. This knight feels a bit shaky here with bishop d3, rook e1 coming up. But I can strengthen it with bishop b7, queen e8. Now I need to watch out for some c5, c6. c5, I can get this bishop out after taking first here. Still, there's a bit of pressure for white. I'm not completely out of. c5, I can take and play bishop a5. That is useful. Although, I'm not sure how it goes. c5. BC DC. Okay, good that it didn't happen. He wants to add pressure here. I can of course relieve a bit of it with h6. Rook e1, I'm not sure how I will intend to respond, but I think I need to come back with 96. Not easy to make moves. The moves don't flow in this position. That's because he has good control, and mainly because this bishop on c7 is totally out of place. But also not an obvious square, better square in sight. So I guess I'll just wait. I'll wait for him. He can also do the same thing. Improve this bishop. The most obvious piece that can be improved. A4 is also not a bad move. I think I really need to start putting some pressure here. Bishop a6, yeah. So first intention was to get rook d8, but now I think I'll try and pile on some pressure on c4. Try and reverse things a bit. So far I have been on the defensive. So, good time to reverse this. Did I blunder something? I did, or I haven't. I'm saved by this lucky bishop c2. Although, I do have to face this consequence of d7, the unpleasant consequence. But at least I'm lucky that I'm not losing immediately. Which, he can just take dc7, yeah? So maybe I'm just losing a lot of things. I guess I just got outplayed in this game. I missed c5, which was a consequence of the pressure I was in through very large parts of the game. He didn't see dc7, but maybe he has something better here. He should be having something better for him, or I'm going to be okay. Yeah, I think I'm okay here, and my time situation has also benefited from the transaction. Yeah, I'll just trade. I had this bishop f4, but okay. Immediate priority is to get completely safe. Queen c1 or queen c2. Yeah, this was my immediate priority. I feel I'm completely safe now. And still need to be a bit careful. Okay. Not the best game, but also not such a bad game. Divya's full on making jokes on the comment, yeah? Full on making jokes. Triple seven, that's Haik Martirosyan, who is actually very strong for me. He's actually very fast, very fast. And I'm even slower when I stream. I'm slow in general, but I'm even slower when I stream. So I'll try to play a bit faster than I normally do. Yeah, all the opening preparation done against Haik doesn't help in this 960. But the speed can be used against. This is a good strategic position to have. Good pawn structure here, and yeah, I think maybe not draw arrows and stuff for this game. Yeah, just try and play good moves, and not let him bully me with the speed. I need to bring my pieces before I go in for operations. Very tempting to go g4, e5. g4 should be a good move here. Yeah, now e5 is probably going to run into... at the very least he has knight e8, so... I would very much like it if I can prepare it with my pieces. Knight d2, f4. Or maybe this is a good time to go e5. Yeah? He no longer has this. Look at the speed, my god. He has e6 at any point. So I think he's fine. He was having a pretty dubious position, but now he's out of jail. Cause e6, I can go d6. Not a good thing for him to have. And some knight c3, knight b5. But for all these things to work, I need to be on time to be able to defend this. Time is a very important factor in this question. If I'm not on time, I'll probably just lose this and I'll be worse, which is what has happened, I think. I lose this by force, yeah? Yeah, pretty sure I do. Knight b5 is met with a6, so I should, yeah, I should just, now I should try and defend a pawn down position. Okay. Let's do it. I could have got an A4 in. This will lose the B4. He has to play C4 now. I take and I think I'm winning back a pawn, yeah. Rook C5, Bishop D5. Okay. I'm not really winning back a pawn. But it still feels a bit dubious what he has done. Yeah, so he still has this knight a3 coming and let me try to exchange as many pawns as I can. Good defensive technique is to exchange your pawns. Right now this is not really hanging, but playing like this often it can land into some tricks. I don't feel great about what he has done, but maybe he knows better. But then I can just take this and defend with a3, no? Okay, so he doesn't want to slowly convert. He wants to go for the kill. It also helps that he has such a wonderful bishop here. And it's the problem is it's very tricky to defend against these threats with less time. Good move again, I guess. At least it's a tricky move. Now the threat is Rook G2. And not easy threats to defend with less time. Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to defend this one. I don't see a defense against Rook G2. Okay, my final hope is he gets so complacent about this position, but it's really a very faint hope. Yeah, it's over now, I guess. Okay, it's the end of my first streak, consisting of 3 wins. And that's the score after the first 1 hour. It's going to be 3 hours long. A very, very long arena. We don't know the result of the appeal yet. Hopefully, a weaker opponent. Why is the queen on E8? Okay, first thing, I unleashed my bishops in the best possible way. Now this is also a good strategy in Fog of War. The bishops, we have to try and control with them as many squares as possible. Okay, I don't understand why he wants to exchange his bishop so badly, but if he wants to do it so badly, then I'll try and win some tempos, at least one tempo. Yeah, I guess Divya would have gone to sleep. Yeah, she already overstayed her 11 o'clock sleeping time a bit. This is attacked, so we defend. And why is he so eager to exchange pieces like this? I mean, what's the strategic point? Doesn't this result in loss of tempos? Maybe it's not so bad what he has done, because my rooks don't have any open files. So okay, good position, yeah. But of course, he can run with his king on one move. Yeah, that was bound to happen. But still, not such a bad turn of events. First, I want to control this with d6. It would be nice if I can exchange my queen like this. That is one way I can play. What else can I do? Okay, so the one threat that I'm a bit wary of is b4. So I think I'll block this option. Yeah, now I feel good about the position I have. I just gave this up. But that I did not expect from him. The pawns feel a bit disjointed, but I can connect it with a5 next move. It's like fixing wires in Among Us. I missed this move. Hopefully not. Oh, there is some strategy compensation for sure. Strategy compensation. Not much though. Main thing is his king is very, very away from the scene of play. And it's not easy for white to access my pawns as of now. Yeah, this was what I expected. Now the thing is, he cannot really kick my rook from the 7th rank. He says he doesn't want to, it doesn't matter. Okay, I'll fix this. This is the strategy compensation. Whatever pieces are remaining, I'm able to... So now he wants to kick me out from here, yeah? Okay. Yeah, I should play for, I should play a bit faster for sure. That is a definite area of improvement. But it's also something I don't mind in the early stages of the arena. I wish I had this protected, but it is not, so how does that leave my chances here? I have this one, threatening this. I didn't see bishop before check initially. Now rook g4, yeah, this is winning. This is winning because I'm 2 pawns up. Generally 2 pawns up should win. I'll just cover this just in case. Although this leaves this weak, but I should be able to take this pawn if he tries too much and... yeah. Yeah, okay. Fine. No need to be too greedy and try to hold on to all the pawns. Kind of important to advance my own pawns fast. Not that easy for him to advance this, and therein lies my advantage in this push. Okay, why did I allow that? I specifically had my king there not to allow that. But I looked at the chat for 1 second and I ended up allowing it. Funny. Okay, these pawns are too fast. And a general rule. If 2 pawns get on the 6th rank, the rook cannot catch it. 2 pawns together on the 6th rank, the rook is helpless. And now I can just give my rook for this pawn. It's one simple way to win. Okay. That was nice. What's going on in chat? Who is cool for the chess? American. Wait. He's not. I don't think he's American. Maybe he is. I don't know. There's a person called Cool64Chess. I'm guessing that's not this person. I just blended upon. Yeah. I'm not going to get compensation for that. But I'll pretend that I do. It's not such an expensive pawn to lose, to be honest. But I don't like his bishop here. Bad start. I need some help from him to bounce back from here. I'm eyeing this pawn. How is he going to defend it? Yeah, I guess not quite what he was expecting. Dangerous stuff, but understandable because my bishops are so out here. Understandable from his point of view to try and exploit it. Now, what can I do? Okay, I'll also not take the bishop. I want to get my pieces out. And maybe not the smartest decision I could have taken though. Yeah, this was what I was expecting precisely. So I thought I'll play Qc3 check, an important intermediate move, and then I'll take here. This gives me some real attack. So should I? Yeah, I think I should just take this. Now my position is not bad at all. Now my position is not bad at all, and I think I'll just make one move b4 just to close the a-file. Because I have this Qc4 check move, it's not going to threaten anything. Good thing is I played this game a bit fast, so yeah, so one idea I had was to get f5 in. And otherwise also I can just play bishop f3 or something, I don't know. No, I'll just take this, why complicate things? Then I'll come back and I'll play f5. F5 is a threat. Okay, you can play queen d4, but then f5 comes, threatening to take with check. Yeah, the idea was to take this and keep these two files closed. Also doesn't hurt that I'm up a couple of pawns. Is f5 useful here or no? I don't know. But I'll play fast anyway. Yeah. This feels so risky from him. It's bound to be something. At the very least, I have queen f6 check. But perhaps that's also what I have at the very most, because rook f6 check, king g7. I have rook g6 check, okay. Yeah, this I'm sure he missed. So again on fire, again on a streak. Very far from the top places, but I think these blitz arenas are much harder. You kind of need to berserk a lot from what I know. And I'm not fast enough to berserk and beat people. Yeah, there he goes. I wonder if it's etiquette for me to berserk back. It probably is. So I'll just check what to develop and I'll berserk back for now. Because all the etiquette flies out of the window if I'm desperate. But here I'm not yet desperate. So when you berserk, also you lose this 2 second increment, which used to be there. Oh, I'm clearly in slow mode, like my chat. What? That was strange from him. He clearly missed something huge here. He just didn't berserk on the time control, but he also played the game on berserk mode. So for those who are just tuning in, this is the title arena, Chess 960. Similar to the bullet arena that I had played earlier, but this is chess 960 and this is 3+2. It's a blitz arena. And do like the stream and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Back against Amin Basim. Okay, this time I need to be tactically more alert. I think the previous time I played a good game, but I just got tricked, and I'll try to be more alert this game. A7 is not really hanging, but I need to be careful if I play something like knight d6. Okay, I developed a piece. developed peace, and I'm also not too this more I didn't expect, but of course it was natural from him. But can't I play d5 here? Ed bishop d5, queen d4, doesn't look great. I'll just move away my queen. For now. So it's not bad what he has gotten himself, the potion. Good potion from the opening. If I play d5, then this is RIP. So, first develop pieces. Next move is knight c3. Okay. My position is not so bad, but I also don't feel so great about it. The moves are not flowing naturally. This is the problem. But I do hope it will be a bit of a temporary problem. Probably not a great decision. He can take this actually. I was counting on f4, but he can take this also. After queen. Ah, okay. Queen g5, knight e6, check knight e6. Okay. This I'm lucky to have. Okay, despite my luck, my position hasn't improved so greatly. But okay, not a disaster as well. Important thing to play fast, not to get too low on time and get under pressure. Playing fast definitely helps in blitz. This pawn is dangerous, so I think I'll but if I don't take this, he'll play c3. So I'll take this first. Yeah, this was kind of what I expected. If I go knight f5, then he comes knight g5 himself, and I probably should take this, yeah. But also not a great situation then. But yeah, I should probably take this just in case. Okay. This pawn is the problem actually. This pawn I can take easily, but this pawn is going to just gallop. He plays bishop g6. Okay, fine. I was for one moment happy that I managed to catch this, but it's still not easy for him. But this time situation is far from ideal. How is he going to improve his position is the question I'm asking him. So far I'm holding things tight, but he can of course advance his king. King c3, c5 and then do something. Not sure what though. There's this leeches chat and I see people playing Among Us on the leeches chat. Someone is asking, is the vent connected to another one? Kill yellow and vent. Purple kills yellow and vent. Okay. Not the more expected. He wants to open the B file, okay. Good. Not a bad idea from him. No. Okay. I definitely missed something though. Okay, this I have to survive for 50 moves. Not easy on seconds. But okay, he also has only some seconds. Making some progress. Should be around 30 moves, 20 more moves to go. Feel like I'm getting close to 50 moves. That was a tough draw. But I'm happy that I defended this rook, bishop versus rook. That was not at all easy with less time. So the strategy I followed was to just keep one square distance between my king and rook. It's I think one of the simplest defensive methods. Yeah, Raven X, that was kind of expected. That was expected. Magnus was losing. So his 125 game winning streak comes to an end. But yeah, okay, all good things come to an end. And it's useful not to get too attached to these streaks, you know, because if we get too attached, then it kind of can affect our creativity. I don't know who this person is, but I think I'm going to berserk back. It's okay to follow etiquette unless things get too desperate. So it's possible. No, yeah, I do in this piece. Yeah, I do in this piece, but can't really sit back and relax yet, considering the faster nature of this game. Things definitely under control so far. Okay. This one is. Yeah, I know the name. I know it's Alexander Rustemo, but I don't know him, you know. Yeah, Magnus lost to Dula, I know. This is Rasmus Soane from Germany. I think you may have seen him in. You may have seen Vidit playing him in his stream. Young player from Germany, quite fast. Hitting me on C2. He's about 2600. And BA5 was not a good decision by me. Not a smart move. We are actually playing pretty fast, yeah. Have to, I mean. Otherwise, I'm just suffering with less time and getting under pressure. And as I mentioned early, I'm no Nihal Sarin. Just get here. Okay, sure. Welcome, 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 Queen. Oh, not the welcome I wanted to give. This is what happens when I play too fast also, which is why I play slow in the first place. This is why anyone plays slow in the first place, you know, when we play fast, we play badly. Hemant, I'm 26. There has not been an update on the fair play appeal. I absolutely have no idea why he spent so much time for that move in that position where he's completely winning. I'm not even like seriously putting up any stiff fight here. I mean, two knights are not the greatest combination in the world, so he was just a piece up. Okay, this is over in any case. Okay, it was not quite the 125 game unbeaten streak, but I did have a streak of 5 undefeated games before that. Magnus lost in the Norway chess tournament. You can find more about it by probably googling about it or go to any major chess platform. And Lee Chess does have their anti-cheating detection system, so it's not that easy. Of course, it's possible, it's not impossible. But okay, I'm really just looking to have fun, so I don't mind. It too much. It's nice to have these kind of fun events every month actually. Leeches arenas are some of the most looked forward to events. I'm just making fast moves so far, not necessarily strong moves. Now I'm stuck because the spawn is weak. Okay, let me open the G file anyway. It is a sort of bullet game from here on, so. On B4. Totally not intended. I just luckily found this queen at 6 hit. But all said and done, in the end, it's equal material. Very importantly, I have like 20 seconds more. As long as I'm not getting mated here, this should be fine. I have to be careful here. Okay, so far Berserk so good. Maria Zagallo, very far in the lead. This is Shant Sargsyan. No, I don't think I'll berserk back against him. But also important to play good chess. Not to play too fast and get carried away by his speed. I exactly what happened. People who berserk, they tend to be actually much more alert in general, because they have less time to play with. Okay, I'm hitting this, but this gets hit, so I'll not take that option for now. Yeah, I think this one I'm going to lose, despite my overwhelming time odds. Always a bit tricky when your opponent berserks and you don't. You need to be wary of not missing these tactics. People with less time, they are tactically so much more alert. But here my job should be to try and prolong the game as long as I can. Okay, this one seems to be in the bag. Although it's of course going to be very difficult for him always. Berserking in this 3 plus 2 arena. The Berserker loses half the time plus also the increment. But okay, it was his conscious choice to Berserk. Who is Ikicha 77? Ivan Ivanisevic. Well, Grandmaster above 2600 rating. Very strong. He plays Benoni here also. He's, I think he plays Benoni. That's his main opening and he has played that structure here. I cannot support it with e4 because I think I'll lose this pawn. So I lose considerable opening advantage because of this. I mean, not considerable opening advantage, but I would have preferred to keep my pawn structure a bit different. And d5 shouldn't have a load. No, actually, maybe I'm surviving due to this tactic I have. But maybe not. Yeah, I gotta go bishop f4, otherwise I'll get hit with d4. And he has got a fantastic position. I've been outplayed in the opening. No, Nihal wouldn't berserk every game. Without increment, it's very tough. There are some guys who are very good at this berserking. I think Fedosiev and Parham Aksudlu. And generally they dominate in these arenas. Okay, d4, knight e4, am I losing a pawn? Not yet, yeah. Kind of hoping for some trick to survive on. In IT4 is one of those tricks. By Deep Narayan. Why is he allowing knight e4? There is some music in the background, Ninad. Should probably yeah, because my position was strategically bad. Despite that trick, it hasn't improved so greatly. What to do? It's the consequences of the bad decisions we make early in our lives. This doesn't feel great from him. Yeah, I wanted this spawn. Knight C6 is coming, yeah. We'll take this. Yeah, I've tricked my way into a good position actually. Oh, he blended into a mate. Kind of like how I wanted. King h6 is rook h5 mate. And if he goes to the 8th rank, then it's rook e8 mate. Oh, I'm playing the player in the first place. I don't know who this is. I don't know who is GM. Anyone knows who he is? Yeah, feels like a nice and solid position till now. Probably threatening e4, yeah? I think which is what he wanted from the beginning. So then, how am I going to respond against e4? I don't know yet. Just that it's not pleasant to face. This much I know. But maybe I can casual shot and turn the tables around. So there are two ways, yeah. I can start with e5, I can take this and then play e5. I don't like this option of taking and playing e5 because of d5. So maybe I play e5 first. Nah, I lose something here. No, I think I have to accept that I didn't play optimally like the previous game and just sit and play slightly worse position. Yeah, I mean it's not such a bad position actually. He wants to take this or play g4. If I play h5, he'll take knight f5. If I play g6, then g4. Maybe I should have guarded this, yeah? Now he's going to hit me here. Why did I allow this? Why did I allow this? If I play b4, he intends to meet it with c4. So I can bring this knight to e7. Seems like a sensible thing to do. I hallucinated a bit that I had this rook, but okay, I'm still not losing control of the g file yet. It's of course a bit scary to play against the arena leader, to be honest. Because it has to be someone quite strong to lead the arena. I hope I'm not losing anything. I guess not yet. Not yet, but I am getting strategically outplayed. I move this knight, then c5 is it. I'm getting squeezed. Yeah, I knew it, but I was under pressure, and when you have like so many threats to deal against, you tend to miss one. It's probability. I'm losing here. It's like his pieces has entered my position. It's like ship has entered the water. Water has entered the ship, and. Good idea for me to resign and, you know, focus on other people. This guy's like way ahead, you know. He should be some 2700 plus for sure. Mario Zagalo. Second is Arvind Chidambaram. Fourth is Dmitry Andreykin. Fighterman 91. I have played against this person a few times. I think from Armenia. Ah, no, it's Darini Puria. Okay, he's from Iran. I have played him a bit in all this childhood events and stuff. Okay, why did I play h3? Strange move, yeah? I should have played maybe some queen e2. Just invites g5, g4. Also gives options of bishop f3. I'm starting to get a bit tired, to be honest. I'm starting to miss some moves of my opponent, but it looks like a two-way street. This was a pretty bad miss by my opponent. So it's a blunder by him, yeah? I mean, why did he give up such a good exchange? Did he see it? Or did he not? I don't know. But yeah, the thing is, I was intending queen d3, but he has queen h6, so he's still in the game. For a few moments, I thought I was completely winning. It's the third hour of this arena, and it's starting to take effect on the way I see things. I should probably take a break after this game, a small break, a 5-minute break, and be back. Probably not sleep click. Yeah, could be sleep kicking in as well. I actually woke up early in the morning today. Not early early, but you know, samay raina standard of early. So I actually woke up in the morning, which is early for this samay raina standard of early morning waking up. Also, playing constantly for 2 hours, it takes its toll on you. You do feel a bit tired unless you are a bit amped up on chemicals like adrenaline or you know, yeah, that excitement keeps you going. I'm not getting anything here, so I think I'll I really wanted bishop e4. I wanted to exchange this, but bishop e4, he just goes knight g7. I'll just exchange the queens and play. Yeah, now I need to find a satisfactory way to, yeah, I'll just bring back my bishop. I'll play normal simple chess. Why complicate things too much? This is not a good fixture for me. Yeah, this could probably be one of those last late night streams. Yes, Arjun, exactly. Caffeine is could be greater than adrenaline. I'm probably going and making some coffee for myself. I'll take a 5-minute break after this game. And